Hello YouTube. So, we've received a box from JLPCB. It's our moon lamp custom circuit board, partially assembled with SMT mounted components. So on the board, we have the linear regulator to take our voltage from 5 down to 3.3. We have our output drivers that take the PWM signal from the ESP32 and connect it through to the 5 volt supply. And we have some indicator LEDs for RX, TX, 5 volts and 3.3 volts. So let's get the ESP32 soldered on. So I've aligned the ESP to the position on the PCB where it should go, and I've taped it down. So I'm going to connect a few of the pins just to hold it in place. And then once we've got some of the pins soldered in, we can remove the tape and solder in the rest of the pins. Now, there's going to have to be some cleanup of the joints where we've got joined joints, so I'll use my solder sucker to clean those up a bit later. So we'll carry on soldering. Obviously, this is highly speeded up. I didn't think you wanted to watch the full long process of the soldering. So we'll carry on soldering up the ESP32. Now, some of the pins are quite tricky to solder. Things like the ground pins and the 3.3 volt pins are quite hard. We have quite a large ground plane, so ground pins can be quite hard to solder. And the 3.3 volt pin has quite a thick track. So I'll bring in my bigger solder bit later to actually solder those. So just touching up some of these solder joints. And now we'll use our solder sucker to clean up some of the bridge joints. So you need to clean off all the flux with a bit of alcohol. And now I'll just touch up some of these joints with the bigger solder iron. So that's the ESP soldered up. I've soldered on the header pins, and I'm just soldering in the last components, which are the screw terminals. So that's our board all soldered up. So let's give it a quick clean to remove any flux residue. And now we can move on to actually testing it. So what I'll do is I'll wire up my USB to UART board, and we'll download the simple blink sketch. So hit the program button and we should see the TX LED start to flash. So here we go, the program's downloading. And now we just need to disconnect the programming pin from ground and hopefully we should see a blinking LED. So our board seems to work. It's not the best soldering job, but we seem to have our joints okay and it's working. So I'll download the prototype software for the moon lamp and let's wire up the LED and see if it works. So I'm using the web interface for the board. So let's see if I can control the LED. So this is the red channel. And now the green channel should come on. And now the blue channel. So looks like our board is fully functional and seems to be working as designed. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a bit of a blast through my custom ESP32 board. There are detailed videos of the design process and PCB manufacture in the channel. I'll put links in the description. Hope you enjoyed this short video, and if you did, please hit the subscribe button and hit the bell as well so you know when new videos are released. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.